What's up, guys? Back with another one. I'm Ryan, my man George.
Papa, guys, how you living out there?
Las Vegas coming back at you with an unbiased real reaction.
That's right. Shout out to our free thinkers, of course.
Yeah, man, and our patrons.
That's right.
You know this is an early access video for this Nas. I know y'all, the streets need this one, George.
Yeah, we need it. We need it.
Yeah, we shall.
We need this. Yeah, guys, look, man, we don't have to tell you how excited we are about this album, man. Nas is a Mount Rushmore, is on my personal Mount Rushmore rap. He's one of the greatest MCs to ever do it. And I just love the fact that he's still able to, at this point, demand so much attention with a project.
Right,
you know what
right.
I mean? It just speaks to his greatness.
At this point in his career.
At this point in his career.
It's crazy, you know?
Teaming up with Kanye West, I mean,
and
I think...
what do you think about that collabo? What do you think? I think this is going to be fire.
I hope so.
I hope so, too. I'm trying to bring myself down because I know had a 5 hour. I'm a little excited.
Good, well, you know, this is what we wanted from Nas. Anyone who's ever listened to Nas has always kind of gotten criticized for some of his production. You know what I'm saying? Some people think that Nas's production has been fine.
It's fine,
but
right.
There's always been a sector of hip hop that's looked at Nas's production as sort of lacking.
Right.
Lyrically, you don't ever have to really worry about Nas not bringing it.
Right.
But it's just, man, if we could just match Nas up with this person,
right.
It's always been that. So,
and this is
here
that.
We go.
This is that partnership right there.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
All right, man, so let's get into the album, Nasir. First song is gonna be Not For Radio.
Hey, man, we ain't posing for no pictures in 2018. Candy shit only. Scared motherfuckers. Black Kemet gods.
Yeah.
Black.
Sorry, bud. Yeah. Rekindling the flame from
yeah.
Hate Me Now with Puff Daddy. All right, let me bring that back.
Scared motherfuckers. Black Kemet gods.
Yeah.
Black Egyptian gods. Shoot the ballot box. No voter card. They all are frauds.
Mm.
Senegal's finest. Minerals, diamonds. The earth is cursed, but I survived many climates. This ain't knowledge. This is not intense for honored men. Women too. Us two can see the same thing, but have a different view.
He said down here, this is knowledge. This is not intense for honored men. So when you're honorable and you know your history and you know what's going on, right? You've done your due diligence and really gone back and studied history. This isn't intense. It can come off intense, some of the things he's saying, right? Shoot the ballot box, no voter cards, they all are frauds. It can come off as sort of really like politically charged and racially, but the reason why he's saying this is because there's an imbalance, right, in society. You know what I'm saying? There's an imbalance. There's sort of the playing fields aren't equal.
Right.
And when you understand that, you know that, lines like this type of rhetoric, not for radio and all this isn't controversial. But it will be controversial. Because motherfuckers don't know what they should be knowing, you know what I mean? So I just thought that line really stuck out to me.
I agree with you, man.
So Nas doing what Nas does, man. Just giving wisdom, educating, talking real shit.
Yeah, man.
Let's get back to it.
Mm. Abe Lincoln did not free the enslaved. Progress was made because we forced the proclamation.
Fuck your proclamation.
SWAT was created to stop the Panthers. Glocks were created for murder enhancement, for hunting men. Convinced my experiences were meant to be. Helps me navigate as they validate their treachery. Felt established, fake as he smiled, handshake questionable. In my hood, fear does a few things. Make you pussy, make you a snitch, make you rational moves, or even turn you to fool.
I think they scared us. We don't care about what you think about us.
You're lucky God made us compassionate and forgiving. We see that bitch in your eyes.
Yeah, man, I think this is fire so far. I'm liking the chorus, I'm liking the beat, I even like the choir that they got, that in the background, because it's almost like he's taking us to school, he's preaching. He's bringing in true facts about history and black culture, because that's one of the things that I've always thought was needed in school and coming up, and not just black culture, guys, just different culture in general. We don't teach it.
Yes.
You know what I mean? We just don't. And I think this is really, really good for young people to obviously know, and even for me, it's education to me as well, because I'm not the best on history, but I think so far, man,
great intro. Great intro, dude. To me, what I got from this man is Nas is just teaching. He's educating, right?
Yes.
Why, to me, when he's going through all this, when he says the SWAT was created to stop the Panthers, the Black Panthers, you know, Glocks, guns were created for murder enhancement. You know, why is he saying the things that he's saying? You know what I mean? It's about educating. It's about enlightening individuals so they understand what's really going on out here. You know what I mean? So that there's a bit of revisionist history in history books.
Yes, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So know your history. When you know your history, what does that do? it instills a certain level of pride, a certain level of sort of confidence. Mm-hmm. You know, and what does that confidence do? It makes you want to go out and make things happen. It makes you want to go out and make change. You know what I'm saying? So I think that, to me, is what Nas has always been about. It's not anti anything else. It's just about, you know, motivating and inspiring people to think bigger.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? So that, to me, is a perfect, perfect intro.
First song.
It was fire. For the radio, because that fits Nas. You know, Nas is... You know, he's
got a couple.
He had a couple of joints where he chased the genuine Omi. You know what I'm saying?
That was hot.
That was hot. Yeah. It was hot to me. But for the most part, Nas has never really chased the radio.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So this is just standard procedure for Nas. Mm-hmm. So dope. Like that joint. Let's get to the next one.
Yeah, man. All right, guys. So the next one is Cops Shot the Kid. So pretty straightforward on that one, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, so
here we go, man.
Yeah.
Cops used to come around, you know, in my neighborhood. All right, you kids, stop having so much fun. Move along. All right, niggas have to be home by 11.
That's Richard Pryor. Sounds like it.
And you be trying to get home, you know, doing your crew runs. Put your hands up, black boy.
The cop shot the kid. Children's story.
Yeah.
Slick Rick. Classic joint.
Slick Rick the Ruler, baby.
Yep. You know, Nas, another thing about Nas, he's always paid homage to, and that's the thing that's missing from this generation, man, you know? Paying homage to those that came before you, man. That's what the 90s had. You know, 90s, our heroes had their shortcomings, but one thing that they always did, they always reached back. Nas always bigs up Rakim and Slick Rick.
Yep.
Right? Big Daddy Kane. Man, that was a thing.
And you know? Even if you didn't agree with the music that they made, which Nas did, but even if you didn't, it was just respectful to do. I think the respect level.
You have to respect it.
Oh my goodness. That's really, when you say generational gaps, to me, the biggest word that comes, the most poignant word that comes to mind is respect.
Yeah, that's it. You don't have to like it.
Exactly.
But you better respect it.
You know?
All right, let's get back to it. Sorry, man. We just had to point that out. Yeah. Shout out to Slick Rick the Ruler, baby.
I don't want to hurt nobody. We just came here to party. Slap boxing in the street. Crack the hydrant in the heat.
Yeah.
Cop cars on the creek. Doing their roundups. We just watch for the sweet. Together we'll be strong, but forever we divide.
Woo.
So y'all are blowing my high. How in the hell the parents gonna bury their own kids, not the other way around?
Woo.
Let's remind them why Cap kneels.
Dude, man.
Nas is different, man.
Before you get into that, though, I gotta shout out Kanye for this sample. To be able to take that Slick Rick verse, because that's a verse in that song. That original Slick Rick song, that's not a chorus. You know, he took a verse and made it a chorus and looped it.
That's right.
And he looped.
This ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh.
Right, you know what I'm saying? And he looped the damn Richard Pryor scream.
Yeah.
In a comedy special. Yeah. In his comedy skit. Dude, I mean, we ain't even got to Nas yet, but that right there takes some notice. And dude, man, that's fire, man.
Yeah, man. Let's keep it rocking, man.
Yeah, man.
Stay tuned up and down your timeline. This fake news, people, is all lying. Money is being made when a mob cries. Tell me who do we call to report crime. If 911 doing a drive-by. It's certain things that can't abide by.
I'm sorry, oh, come on, Kanye. Tell me, who do we call to report a crime if 911 doing a drive-by?
Mm.
There's some controversy in there, but at the end of the day, what they're talking about is, you know, violence. You know, police brutality or whatever the case may be in these poverty-stricken neighborhoods. And just speaking from my experience, guys, when I grew up, I was scared of the police, man. I was very, very scared of the police when I grew up, man. And I just think that, I think everyone has a little bit of fear of the police in general. But growing up in the south side of Chicago where we grew up, dude, you don't call the police. Mm-hmm. The police is not going to help you. That's the mindset of how I grew up, which obviously is skewed. But my point of saying that is I can really identify with that line because, dude, that's the product. I was a product of my environment at that point in time in my life.
Yeah, man, real shit. Yeah, shit, let's keep it going, man.
I know every story got two sides. Claiming he paranoid by the black guy. Cop wanna make a home by nighttime. Had a little hit, he wasn't that high. Cop gon' claim that it was self-defense. Say he was riding dirty, so the case rents. Making ends meet. Shot him this week.
Cop shot the kid, I still hear him scream.
Yeah, man, this was, I don't know how I feel about that sample being used throughout the entire song.
Okay.
That's my whole thing about the beat. It's like, you know, the sample to me is a little much constantly throughout the entire song. I do think the beat is cool. It's not bad. But I would have liked that sample to be, I would have liked to hear that sample in the chorus and let that
and let the beat rock out.
So the sample was actually a little annoying to me.
But the creativity of that?
Very creative. Kanye's always going to be creative. Yeah. You know what I mean? But his experiments, depending on who you talk to, aren't always successful. You know what I mean? So for me, the sample is annoying constantly throughout the entire song. But I love what the sample's about. Yeah, man, I love Nas's verse, man. I love how he started it. We don't want to hurt nobody. We just came here to party. See a few Daves, exchange some names. Slap boxing in the street, yep. Crack the hydrant in the heat.
You sure about that slap boxing in the
street?
Slap
all day, man. lethal. You know what I'm saying? Well, I was lethal. It's been a while since I got busy. But, you know, slap boxing in the street, just playing around, having a good time. Young kids in the hood having a good time. Mm-hmm. But they still have to have an awareness of the police, right? That correct. Police presence, like Ryan said, you kind of have to be cognizant of that. And that speaks volumes, right? It speaks volumes to what the reality is, what their truth is,
right?
You know, and seeing and having with young black youth, their dealings with the cops on a day-to-day basis. You know, you can't always see in the numbers and the statistics on what cops killed this, and don't really reflect day-to-day life between young black youth and the police. You know, you can't see how many times a cop stopped mm-hmm. and frisked someone or harassed a young kid. So there's that. That my point in bringing that up is. That's real.
It's not just a stigma.
It's not just a stigma.
Yeah, I get
that
it.
Is a truth. So I think that people, you know, they'll hear this and they'll just hear complaining. There'll be a lot of people that just hear, oh man, you just think all police are bad. No, not all police are bad, but there is a clear and present danger. You know.
That's true.
You know, when it comes to cops and urban youth, it is. That's their truth. So this is real. It comes from truth. Is the point I'm trying to make. Together we'll be strong, but forever we divide. Is another line that I like. Right.
What I like about that line to piggyback on that is it's not only a division within our culture. Is there's already the division between living in the hood, being black. And police.
Right.
Now we have the division between each other.
That's
on
right.
top of it.
That's right.
You know, mm-hmm. how can you win?
That's right.
How can you? Yeah. How can you inspire change when you can't even come together?
That's right.
As a people.
Yes.
Forget. Let's take the police out of it for a minute. You know what I mean? That's a problem, man.
Yeah.
So I love that, man. I love that.
Yeah. Kanye, man, had a great verse. You know what I'm saying? It was cohesive. You know what I'm saying? Very structured. He got his point across. Yeah, man, I love this part of Ye's verse, man. I know every story got two sides, claiming he paranoid by the black guy. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Cop want to make it home by nighttime. And then Ye is saying, just a good kid, he wasn't that guy. He's showing you that there are two sides to a story,
mm-hmm.
right? The cops are paranoid. They're, you got to understand that these cops are foreign to this environment as well,
mm-hmm.
right? So if you're foreign to an environment, you know, especially in the hood, there's violence and there's crime and all this other stuff, you're going to be on high alert.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so you may irrationally, you know, act out because you want to make it home to your family.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So I know every story got two sides. So I love how he played that other side. And but also, what he's saying is it's unfortunate because, you know, a lot of times these are good kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? He wasn't that guy. He wasn't the guy that the cops should be harassing and shooting, right?
Or that the cops thought he was.
Right. Or that he thought he was.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, you know, shout out to Nas and Ye for spitting some real shit, though. All right, man, next joint is White Label.
A vet stallion in that gala. Got it hard to quit the bottom feed a lobster eater. When I fast, I see Elijah's features. Laying on the most suspicious bed. Still I'm losing sleep. Next to Jets, beauty of the week, 1993.
He's painting such a beautiful picture of a lavish lifestyle. But I love this line when he said, God, it's hard to quit the bottom feeder, lobster eater. When I fast, I see Elijah's features. So I think he's talking about Elijah from the Quran, and who was, I believe, a miracle worker, I believe. You know, I'm not familiar with the Quran, so all Muslims, please, you know.
Right.
But I know a little something, you know. And I believe that what he's saying here, man, is you're living this lavish lifestyle. You're moving fast.
Right.
You're seeing a lot of success, right? You're indulging in the success. But you also have to have these moments of clarity. You have to have these moments in time, man, when you fast and you see
yourself.
Things. You separate yourself from
yeah.
from the success so that you can understand, obviously, what's important.
Mm-hmm.
So when I fast, I see Elijah's features. So I love that about Nas. Nas is human. He always showcases his humanity in his music. Like, look, you know, even down in here when he was like, when he was talking about, you know, next to Jets, beauty of the week, 1993. He's mm-hmm. laying with women. He's in expensive bed. So he's talking his shit. But he always brings you back to reality. He always has sort of a realness that he has a sort of grounded quality that he always displays in his music, regardless of if he's talking about boastful shit. You know, he kind of has a solid foundation. Always brings you back to the solid foundation. So I like that.
Dope, man.
Let's keep it going.
What you love could kill you like a heart physician who dies from a heart attack. I know the consumer behavior, I target that. You impressed with what they wear and I started that.
Woo! I was slick, baby. He said, first of all, I like the line.
The physician. Yeah, I know that's what got you first.
He said, and the odds is that what you love can kill you, like a heart physician who dies from a heart attack. A physician who loves medicine, ironically, can die from a heart attack. What you love can kill you.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So what he's saying here is this: living a fast, lavish lifestyle can kill you.
Yes, it can.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to be able to slow down. That's kind of what I was talking about up top. You know, so, you know, what you love can kill you like a physician with a heart attack. Mm-hmm. And then he said, I know the consumer behavior. I target that. You impressed with what they wearing, I started that.
Yeah.
I always tell people that Nas was like one of the first fly rappers. You know right. what I'm one of the first rappers to really, you know, rock the gold, the gold chains, and had a fly leather jackets, the fatigues and all that, the big glasses, the gazelles and all that. I don't know about that. You know, Rakim might have been number one with the gold
rope chains. Yeah, that's true.
Four finger rings and all that. But Nas was probably like the first
to swag it out.
First, like, really cool-looking rapper. Like, he looked the part. He dressed very nice on a mainstream level. You know what I mean? So when he says, I started that, you impressed. I target that. I already know. I've been doing this for years, for eons.
Yep.
I've been doing this fly shit. I know how to target my consumers. I just thought that was fire.
Super big boy talk, but still letting you know that, dude, I've been there. I've been there. I've done that. Just the label on the package. That's you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
It's kind of terrific. The product is slick rich. Somebody would have told me then I'd come out of this shit rich. We building businesses. You could be mad if you want.
So I think in this track, to sum it up, man, is, you know, Nas, man, he's talking his shit. You know what I'm saying? He's letting you know at this level what he's doing.
Yeah. Like,
this is where he's at. At this level, this is how I play. But at the same time, you have to stay grounded, man.
And he's got a maturity level that I think comes with time, right? Yep.
Absolutely. Nas shows you his humanity. He shows you, like, dude, don't get it to us. Just because I'm a man that has integrity and honor, it doesn't mean that I don't indulge. It doesn't mean that
I don't know how to, like, overindulge.
Overindulge.
Like, I don't know how to get... I can get busy. I can fuck up some money quick.
I can. Yes, sir. But I can still sort of... I'm centered enough to understand when to slow it down and pull it back.
Right.
So by saying things like, what you love can kill you, like a physician, you know, who has a heart attack, that's him saying, like, yo, that's a reminder. Like, even though I'm living this lavish life, I know when to pull it back. Right? Invest in businesses, I believe is what he said in here as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We build businesses. You can be mad if you want. Right? So, still keeping you grounded, still understanding what the bigger picture is. You know what I mean? So, talk fly, but still understand what's important. Now, with that being said, the production on this one, I don't know about the production, man. Not sure if I'm feeling the production on this one. I like the sample. I like the ambition in the sample. I just think that it's just looped too much. And it really isn't much else to the song but the sample. You know, much else to the production, rather, but the sample. It just seems like it's just... It needs to be something in there. Chop it up. Do something else with that sample. Maybe add harder drums in it. And I do think that Nas, to be honest with you, throughout this entire project, has been a little offbeat during certain parts of the songs. Like, his flow hasn't really been catching the beat. And I just think that they would have benefited from maybe another week of just kind of ironing out some of these sort of inconsistencies. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You know, lyrically, Nas is always gonna be great. I just think that this sample in particular just needed a little bit more. It just seemed to be a constant loop without much added to it. You know what I'm saying? So this is alright. This is cool. You know what I'm saying?
I have to agree with you. I didn't like the sample at all, but I don't know where that sample is from. Help me out, guys, because that sounds like that's from something. That's dated from something, an older song. So maybe I may have a little bit better appreciation for the song if I knew where the sample came from. But one thing I wanted to touch on, man, when you were talking about what you love can kill you, I agree with you. I really think that was really the foundation of this song. You know what I mean? Like, what you live in that fast life can kind of kill you. And when he was talking about the lobster eater, bottom feeder, I think that's what that statement rings true, right? Because lobster is fire, right? Lobster is not cheap, right? So you live in a lavish lifestyle, but it's necessarily not good for you because they are bottom feeders. Mm-hmm. They eat the trash of the ocean. So mm-hmm. I think that that's kind of a slick analogy or metaphor of living that fast, lavish lifestyle. And you think it's good for you, but it's bad for you.
There you go.
You know what I mean?
So, excellent. Excellent. That's dope. Yes, sir, man. Great feedback, man. So on to the next joint. We got Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Shout out to our French subs out there.
Mature, sure, I'm spoiled. Hit up the south of France after tour. Bonjour, street metaphor. If your dog piss on the floor, put his nose in it. Check these niggas from the door. Bonjour. Eat at selective kitchens. Speak on our next intentions. Over creamy polenta. It comes chef recommended. She didn't see me coming. Now she's an eyewitness. Laissez les bon temps rouler. Say ah so the kids could play.
Nas talking to him, man. He's talking to him.
Woo! Anybody that knows me knows why I'm laughing about that. That was dope.
She's an eyewitness. She right? didn't see me coming.
Now she's an eyewitness. Coming.
What I love about this, man, is just, it's just showing hip hop from a sort of mature,
classy,
eloquent sort of perspective, man. And it shows Nas's evolution. For those of you who are familiar, man, listen to Illmatic and then listen to this. He wasn't eating at Selective Kitchen. Speak on our next intentions over creamy polenta. That wasn't happening on Illmatic, right? Yep. So this is Nas, right? Which is appropriate. It's showing an evolution of a man who has seen immense success in and outside of music. You know what I'm saying? He's giving you just the grown-up version of Nas. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? And I think it's a beautiful thing to see, man. I'm just happy for him. I'm happy that someone who deserves it, you know what I mean? Who stayed true to himself, right? Who stood for something throughout his entire career, you know what I mean? That never really truly compromised. It's good to see this man living a good life, man. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's inspiring. Let's keep it going.
Vacations I didn't like, put myself through a guilt trip. All these beautiful places, but the cities be poor. You wealthy when your kids upbringing better than yours. Why are you getting pregnant? That's long-term stress.
You know, Nas, again, he always, when he's talking about this lavish shit, he always makes sure that he gives you a grounded perspective to couple it.
Yep.
You know, when he says right here, man, you know, you're wealthy when your kids' upbringing is better than yours. All this money we getting could be gone in a minute if we don't invest it.
Yep.
We long-term affected. Watch who you getting pregnant. That's long-term stressing. Mm-hmm. So he's dropping jewels.
Yep.
When you get to this level, it's not just about getting to this level. It's about level and keeping this fortune, right? Sharing your wealth, making sure your wealth lasts for generations, right? Making sure your kids are educated and up to par and up to a certain standard.
Yep.
So.
Absolutely, man.
Fire. Yeah, man, so what'd you think of that one, man?
You could always depend on Nas to be able to give you bars, right?
Gems as well, yeah.
And really kind of paint the picture and bring it home. I think he did that really well. I'm not really feeling the actual beat on this one. I think this one was very, very, very plain. For me, the record right now, man, is kind of... It's bringing my steam down. Come on, I want to get my hypeness back. I'm losing my anticipation, you know. But always, I'm gonna like Nas regardless, just because he's a pioneer. But that's kind of where I'm at with it right now. So
yeah, man, I think the production has been hit or miss for me. Hit or miss, you know what I mean? Yeah. Even the songs, not for radio. I didn't really touch on that song. I think that. Was a good beat. I think it was a solid beat. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I think more so Nas really was going off on that.
Yep.
Cop Shot the Kid was good. I think I like the skeleton of that. I like the cop shot the kid, the cop shot the kid. I just think that he could have just, it was just too repetitive. Throughout the entire song, we heard the sample. Just keep that for the chorus and let Nas get off and let Ye get off. You know what I mean? Right. So even that beat wasn't like...
Crazy.
Yeah. White label seemed to be too plain. It wasn't really much added to White Label. I think he could have did something better with the drums personally. That didn't really grab me. Bonjour, I like the skeleton of this one. I like that bonjour. I just think it was...
It's missing something, right?
Yeah.
It's missing something.
It seems a bit hollow.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So all the beats, it's not that they're bad. It's just that I feel like they almost come off unfinished. You know what I mean? This project to me... Overall, just seems like it just comes. It's coming off like a bit rushed because Nas's flow has been a little off on some of the tracks, and the beats aren't there needs to be more added to the beats, man. There's more depth to the beats.
And we just expect more from Kanye.
Yeah.
I mean, Kanye, you're great.
Yeah.
He's great, right?
Go listen to My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy right now. Compare those beats to this and go listen to Graduation. Compare those beats to this. You know, you feel that those were a little bit more meticulously crafted.
Right.
All those little details that we like in the production, you know, I feel like are just not quite there for this album. You know what I'm saying?
I agree with you.
Well, not so far, because we're fucking already almost done with this shit.
Well, the next
seven songs.
Well, the next track is called Everything, and that's got Dream, right?
Hopefully it has everything. Everything, Nas, The Dream, and Kanye West.
See, cause you've never been the same as anyone else. Don't think the same as everyone else. Everything, I could change anything.
See, right here. Okay, right here. This is important for me to point
out. Yeah, go ahead, man.
Because I like how the melody sounds. Mm-hmm. But why aren't you using Charlie Wilson for this like you did in the other
shit?
Get Charlie Wilson to sing this shit. You know? And that's why I feel like the whole Rush thing, I just feel like, you know, Kanye has been like a fucking factory, right? He did the Pusha T joint.
Yeah,
he did his joint. He did Kid Cudi's.
Pushing him out.
And he's pushing him out.
Yeah.
And I feel like it sounds like that. I feel like, well, I don't got time to call Charlie Murphy and fly him out here, so let me sing the chorus.
Charlie Wilson. You said Charlie Murphy.
It almost feels like Charlie Wilson would be really good right here, but I don't have time to fucking have him fly out from wherever he's from to
kind of
get this chorus done
and
coordinated.
Yeah.
So let me get it done and I'll sing the chorus. And unfortunately,
Kanye's not a singer.
He's not a singer, and it doesn't sound good vocally to me. It sounds like a rapper trying to sing, and it almost sounds like it could even be for a reference track for somebody else to sing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it bothers me because I really love the way Kanye wrote the melody or Dream, whoever wrote that melody.
Everything.
Yeah. And I like what he's saying. If I change anything, I mean anything, it would change everything. That's beautiful.
It is.
Beautiful writing. Great melody. Just get the right singer, please.
Yeah.
Please get the right singer. And that's kind of been the theme of this whole album. It's just been, you know, Kanye, I love what he's doing. I think it's an ambitious thing to do to tackle this many projects.
Yeah.
But we talking about Nas. We're talking about Nas here. You know what I mean? Take your time with Nas and make sure the flow is right.
Right.
Make sure you add all these little details in the beats like you did before, because this is Nas. This is a collaboration of a generation that we've been waiting for.
That's true.
Yeah, but we just got started. So
yeah.
That's what I just wanted to point that out, because I love the way that sounds, but we got to get a better vocalist, man.
Stop going on to cry. There's too much life left in those eyes. They're just human, let them lie. You just know your world and speak your truth. Let them come to you for your love.
Dream's doing okay. And the thing that I think is carrying this song, and I felt the same way when we did the Ghost Town, check that video out if you haven't checked it out, Ghost Town song, is it was imperfect, but the feeling of it felt good. Like the melodies and all, like this feels very good.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of making up for, in my opinion, the lack of vocals from Kanye. And then also I think Dream is doing good too. I think I like the way Dream's vocals sound on this.
Right.
So, you know, I gotta play both sides, man.
Right.
See, you'll never conclude with anyone else. Don't think the same as
That's
anyone else.
Writing. I love that writing right there. You know, the reality is, man, we're not saying everyone thinks this way, but young black youth have always, you know, been dealt with society looking at them differently.
There's been a stigma.
There's a stigma that young black youth, or just black people in general, have always had to fight.
Mm-hmm.
So when he says, don't think the same as everyone, you're not the same as everyone else. It's a completely different set of circumstances that black people have come up under.
We've always been a little different, you know?
Yeah.
And there's always been a stigma there, but you can be whatever you want to be. You can think the way, it's okay to be different. Now, we all know Kanye has told that line on both ends of the spectrum, but at the end of the day, one thing you can't say about Kanye is he's like everyone else. He's not.
No, he's not. Well said, man. Beautiful. Very, very inspiring, very powerful, powerful lyrics there, man. Mm-hmm. Let's keep it going.
When the media slings mud, we use it to build huts. Irrefutable facts, merciful, beautiful, black. Listen, vultures, I've been shackled by Western culture. You convinced most of my people to live off emotion. That's why we competing. Death by the chrome barrel, forgotten secrets. My killer been Jeroboam, marrow's the deepest.
Yeah, he is going in.
When the media slings mud, we use it to build huts.
Come on, man. When life gives you lemons, you make lemonade, right? That's right.
And when the media tries to make young black youth try to paint this narrative and this picture of young black youth or black people, you know what I mean? We can flip that.
Yep.
He said, listen, vultures, I've been shackled by Western culture. You convinced most of my people to live off emotions. That's why we competing.
Yep.
Death by the chrome barrel, forgot the secrets? Mount Kilimanjaro bone marrow, that's the deepest?
Yo, yep.
What? I've had to live under this sort of regime of Western culture. You convince most of my people to live off emotion, right? And that could be from a lot of different things. Living in a harsh environment, dealing with police, dealing with the media, right? Is what from what they're saying, mm-hmm. making you feel like you're less than.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? What does that do to someone? That drives them crazy, right? It makes them lash out, right? So one of the things that makes them lash out, you know what I'm saying? So we find ourselves now divided and now we're competing amongst each other because mm-hmm. we're lost, right? Death by the chrome barrel forgot the secrets. We forgot who we are. Yep. Culture's gone. Then he said, my Kilimanjaro bone marrow's the deepest. He understands where he comes from. You know what right. I'm saying? Yeah, he knows his culture.
Even with all the obstacles that the culture has endured, we're still doing great.
That's right.
What if we can come together? You know what I mean? That's kind of what beautiful. I'm getting from that, you know?
Beautiful, man. Yeah, so he's going in on this one.
People do anything to be involved in everything. Inclusion is a hell of a drug. Yeah. Some people have everything they probably ever wanted in life and never have enough.
I had everything.
People do anything to be involved in everything. Inclusion is a hell of a drug. That's beautifully written, man.
It is.
I think what Nas is alluding to there, obviously, it's obvious. You know, that's just the nature of man. You know what I'm saying? Everyone wants to be accepted in the eyes of whatever group, society. But what they're saying in this song in general is be proud of who you are. Focus on you. Focus on your truth. And let them come to you. You don't always have to go to you. You don't have to abandon who you are
yep.
to be accepted by them. Right? I think that's just an incredible line in here.
And everyone should think that way.
And then he said, some people have everything they probably ever wanted in life and never have enough. So you can try to chase this high of being accepted, because inclusion is a hell of a drug. You yep. can chase this high and try to do whatever you can to be accepted by people who probably don't give a fuck about you, right? And you'll true. Still never have enough. And that's probably why you feel you don't have enough, right? That's probably why you feel unfulfilled.
Yep.
Right? Learn your truth. Learn who you are. Right? So, absolutely. I thought that was a beautiful line.
In the rush to the brain, looking up at his parents' face like, I thought you would protect me from this scary place. Why'd you let them inject me? Who's gonna know how this side effects is gonna affect me? If Starbucks is bought by Nestle, please don't arrest me. I need to use a restroom and I ain't buy no espresso. Sits back on the bus, sitting, says, screw that bus. Boycotted that bus out of business. The future's us. Yet every citizen's in prison.
Man, he was saying some yeah. shit in there, man. Good Lord.
We could gosh. Spend an hour on this.
Jeez.
So much in there.
Yo, why didn't y'all tell us, man, to leave everything out? Because we should have did a separate video
on just this song. Yeah,
it is. Yeah, this is a lot.
Yeah, man, fire. This verse is fire. He's blacking out here. He said, from the birth of a child, the world is foul. Right. So from being born, you already see the
ills of the world.
Right. Exactly. A parent hates to watch his baby's face taking his first immunization shot. But this is great. A child's introduction into suffering and pain understands without words. Nothing is explained but rush to the brain. Just,
that was real.
Fire. You look up at your parents' face like, I thought you were supposed to protect me from this scary place. Mm-hmm. Right? So the imagery that he's painting here is like, dude, when we come into the world, you learn about the pain and suffering that the world is going to give you.
Mm-hmm.
And you look up at your parents like, you guys are supposed to protect me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I can count on anybody, it's my parents.
That's right.
Right? And you can't even, some things your parents can't protect you from.
The world is foul. The yep. way the world is set up is foul. And you learn that. That's just symbolic of Nas saying, kids learn this. Babies learn this from an mm-hmm. early age. That's how he brought it home. By saying, even your parents can't protect you
exactly.
from all the ills of the world. Mm-hmm. Right? They can't protect you. Beautifully, beautifully written. And that's just the first part.
Yep.
And right here, Eva, I love how Nas kind of touched on the whole Starbucks controversy. There's been a few issues with Starbucks. There was one issue where two men, the people working there called the police on the two guys. Right. They were just waiting on someone to arrive. There was another instance where they wouldn't let a person use the restroom. You know what I'm saying? And I think they've changed their policy as a result. So there's been And obviously these have been black people in these instances. So I love how you touched on that. If Starbucks is bought by Nestle, please don't arrest me.
Yep.
You know, I'm innocent, man. I'm in here just like anyone else. Just getting a cup of coffee. I need to use the restroom to relax. So, man, just to sum that up, man, you know, I love the way he said assume the cuffs the position. You assume that, you know, you're going to be in handcuffs. Maybe even for things that you shouldn't be in handcuffs for, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's almost like revolutionary. It's almost like, you know what? Screw that bus. We can find our own way.
Yep.
But just like Rosa Parks did, that's what he's referring to. Said screw that bus and put that bus out of business. The future's us. It's all about empowering and putting sort of that revolutionary mindset in the minds of young black people or black people in general, man. Mm-hmm. And saying, you know what? If we're not going to get their respect, then we can make our own way. We can forge our own sort of paths.
Absolutely.
And control our own destinies, man. You know what I mean? So I thought that was very well written right there, man. Excellent writing.
If I changed anything, I mean anything, I would change everything.
My first house, 11,000 square feet mansion. It was haunted by dead rich whites. Mad a nigga bought his crib to hang up pictures of black Christ.
Circular driveway. The difference between Nas, man, and a lot of motherfuckers, dude. Nas is crazy lyrically, man. Did you hear what he said? My first house, 11,000 square foot mansion. It was haunted by dead rich whites. Mad a nigga bought his crib to hang up pictures of black Christ. The imagination that you have to have
to come up with that.
It's just a lot of symbolism in that, right? He's saying so much there. What the song to me is entailing, is it's showing that a young black man from the hood can ascend to great heights. And what that also is saying is like, dude, this hundreds of years ago, you know what I'm saying, Nas's ancestors were in the fields for this mansion. And now he's buying this mansion, right? It's showing the future. When he says the future's us, you know, these are the types of sort of symbolic accomplishments he's talking about. You know,
that provides our past, motivation and all that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, our past is not going to stunt our growth. Our past isn't going to stop us from moving forward. Even amidst all of these sort of disadvantages that we have, you know what I mean? So I think that line was really, really well written and just dope, man.
I started liking the look like I ain't had no money. Yellow taxi seats over Maybach seats just to remind me, just to inspire me to lay claim to Pan-African made it happen. The same as anyone else. Don't think the same as everyone else.
At the beginning, I thought Kanye's singing was a little rough, but you know what? He brought it home to me. I really liked the way that him and Dream kind of went back and forth. It really inspired me. That's kind of the theme of this song, was inspiration. Like, you know what? I can do better in life. I can be anything I wanted to be. I don't necessarily need to have money and all that kind of stuff. And I really like the way Nas was talking about all the things that he had. I had 11,000 square foot mansion and all this other stuff. And he really painted the picture, not boasting, but he's painting a picture that you can be anything that you want to be.
That's right.
You know what I mean? You can change the world. And that's kind of the inspiration that I got out of this song. I think that's fire.
Absolutely. I think this has been the best song on the album.
Yeah.
I mean, definitely the best song on the album thus far. We're almost done with it here. But very well said, man. I just think that this was powerful. I thought this was well written. I thought the chorus was beautiful. Dream did an incredible job on this one. Nas is just Nas. And now, after hearing the entire song, the vocals are okay. Mm-hmm. I can deal with the vocals now. Because the entire song is just, it's just a special song.
Yes.
I'm willing to go out on a limb. And this is a first listen, and I'm gonna go out on a limb and say it's one of the best songs he's ever created.
Yep.
This is really one of Nas' best songs, and that's saying a lot.
Yeah.
And I know Nas. I know Nas very well. From Illmatic, it was written to Stillmatic, to Nostradamus, you know, the Nas I Am. I do, you know, the Untitled album. I mean, I've heard them all. You know what I'm saying? I've heard all of Nas' material. And this is so powerful, and I think the timeliness of this record, it couldn't be more timely.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And the thing about that is, this is what Nas has done his entire career. He's made inspiring music like this, always. Mm-hmm. And he's also inspiring people. He's letting them know that you're beautiful the way you are. Stay true to who you are. You don't need to fit in or try to fit in or try to alter who you are to be accepted by society, right?
Yep.
He's saying it's okay.
Yep.
You know what I mean? This is what you can accomplish if you stay true to who you are, right? So I thought this was just a powerful record, man, to sum it up, man. Shout out to all these gentlemen for this one.
And this is what I was waiting on. This kind of collaboration, this kind of masterpiece is what I was waiting on.
Yeah, man. Here we go. I think it's what everybody's waiting on. Let's get into the next joint, Adam and Eve.
The ghetto will fellow the more. Oh my God, they speak venomous on the boy. Oh my Lord, my enemy is fear and I'm sure. Oh my God, but it's a trend for these men to die on their own sword. Journey far, learn who you can be, but you can learn who you are when you around family.
First of all, this to me is like a perfect fit for Nas.
Yeah, this beat.
You know what I'm saying?
You know this beat?
This beat is a perfect fit for Nas. Yeah, this is right up Nas's alley. So the beat is hard. And then Nas just gives you so much wisdom, man. You know, right here is an example. It's a trend for these men to die on their own swords. They hang themselves. They dig their own holes.
Before you even get started.
Exactly.
Get a little bit of fame. Pow.
And then done. Fire though, man. Yeah, let's get back to it.
Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve. Fall too far from the apple tree.
The ghost of gangsters dance. Yeah. Chinchilla shake on the hanger. The force of this banger. Yeah, my language advanced. My
pain
is amazing. I'm just good at existing. Existing in my truth. As long as I enjoy the fruit. Yeah.
Adam and Eve.
I love how he brought that on, right? I'm just good at existing. Existing in my truth. As long as I enjoy the fruit. The fruits of his labor.
Right.
The forbidden fruit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Adam and Eve. So I love how he brought that home. That was fire. But again, just getting into the descriptive lyricism of Nas, man. The ghost of gangsters dance, chinchilla shake on the hanger, the force of this banger. Yeah, my language advanced, my cadence amazing, the voice triggers something. What is this conundrum? The cloud scurry, your spirit rumble, a boyish smile. Like, are you serious?
Yeah, he's killing it. And correct me if I'm wrong, George, man. I feel like when I hear Nas, man, on certain tracks, it feels like he gets, like, I'm about to murder this. Like, it seems like he's like,
This is my comfort zone.
Yeah.
This to me is just like, this could have been on a Firm album. That's what it sounds like to me. So fire.
What come first, piece of the paper? Before I had a piece of paper, peace was in my favor. Before I sat to eat at a table, it had leeches and traitors. Cut the fat from the meat, extract the wheat, bon appetit,
yo,
no
bacon.
What came first, peace or the paper? Money, piece or the money? Before I had a piece of paper, peace was in my favor. Before I had any money, I was at peace with myself. Peace was in my favor. Before I sat to eat at the table, it had leeches and traitors. Cut the fat from the meat, extract the wheat, bon appetit. He said, before I sat to eat at the table, you know what I mean? It had leeches and traitors. So as he was coming up, so how I'm interpreting that is as he was coming up in the game, right? And he had these people in his corner, his people on his team.
Yep.
He realized that they were leeches. They leached off of him and they were traitors, right? They were disloyal.
Yep. Who was in his corner? Who wasn't
who
in
wasn't.
His corner?
So he had to cut the fat from the meat, extract the wheat, got the wheat out of there, bon appetit. Now they can all eat.
Yep.
You know what I mean? That was hard, dog.
Yeah, it wasn't
even trying to rap. And I kind of turned that into a bar. But now they can all eat. But that was beautiful how he played on food and at the table eating.
Yep.
That was incredible, man. And that was real. It had so much substance in that as well. So much wisdom, so many jewels that Nas drops. There's so much in here that I want to stop. And me and Ryan, I'm like,
But it's already going to be long. We'd be here like 3 days breaking this down.
Exactly. Let's keep it going. But that was incredible.
Say something. You stay fronting. But these clowns got false crowns, fictional kings. You broke my heart, Fredo. You bring this thing of ours down to a fable. Be advised, my guy's dying, enterprising at a boss's saving. Insecurities is keeping you disabled. All this money to get, is it less time?
He's gone. Yeah, let's get back to it, man. He's going in. No, man, damn.
Big time. That's typical Kanye right there.
Yep, you get an idea how he chopped it.
Yeah,
that was fire, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, shout out to Kanye on the beat on that one.
Yes.
Yeah, we got everything and we got Adam and Eve. Those, that fire.
Yeah,
you know
man.
What I'm saying?
Big time.
Production-wise. I just thought that I think Everything was the best song, but I think that beat fit Nas,
yes,
his style the best. You know what I'm saying? So I thought
he was in his comfort zone to the 10th power.
Easily.
You could see that. He's like, oh, I'm about to kill it. I bet you in the studio, when he heard that sample, he's like, oh, yeah. I'm about to kill this.
And I just think, to sum it up, man, this is Nas talking about, you know, enjoying the fruits of his labor, but he's also giving you sort of some insight on how to build an empire.
Yep.
Right? And how to control your empire. You know, I mean, certain lines in here that cut the fat, you know what I mean, extract the weak.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you want to sit at the table, you got to control your insecurities and understand, play your position. You know what I mean? So that's how you get to a point. That's how you become a boss.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? That's how you get to the point where you can enjoy the fruits of your labor, is how I'm interpreting that song.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought that was fire, man.
It was, dude. I mean, I'm... You know, what can you say?
What do you mean about that?
Yeah, that was fire.
Nas is in his company right now. All right, let's get to the next joint. All right, man, let's get to the last joint, man. Simple Things.
And I know where I'm going to.
Longevity's eyes, I play with infinity's mind, forever's my guy.
This man said, I'm looking in longevity's eyes, I play with infinity's mind, forever's my guy.
Yep.
Dude, are you kidding
me? Yeah.
I'm looking in longevity's eyes, how poetic is that? I play with infinity's mind, forever's my guy. I'm standing the test of time.
Yep.
I have longevity. You're looking at longevity. He's the epitome of longevity.
Absolutely.
Especially when in the hip-hop sphere. You know what I mean? Since Nas has been crushing shit since 1993.
He's all, forever's my guy.
Forever's my guy. You know what I mean? I play with infinity's mind. You know what I'm saying? I'm here. I've stood the test of time. Let's keep it going.
It's my verses they purchase. Without production, I'm worthless, but I'm more than the surface.
Woo!
Want me to sound like every song on the top 40? I'm not for you, you not for me. You bore me.
There's certain people.
Yeah, he was talking to me. He was talking to me. Yeah, Nas was talking to me. And Jordan is like, yeah, that's what he needs to
say. I had to lean on that a little bit more. Because Ryan has said it past.
Yeah, I have.
But honestly, though, I've even said that I haven't liked a lot of Nas's beat choices as well. You know what I'm saying? I think early in his career, Nas has some of the greatest beats ever in his catalog.
Right.
But he has had albums where I'm like, man, just amazing lyrics. And I wish he would, just focus more on the production. But the bottom line is, he said it himself.
Yeah, he did.
He said it. Never sold a record for the beat. It's my verses they purchased.
Yep.
Without production, I'm worthless, but I'm more than a surface.
Yep.
Want me to sound like every song on the top 40? I'm not for you. You not for me. You bore me.
Dope.
What?
Dope, man.
And it's so true.
And I love the way because that's always been like the elephant in the room for him, right?
Yep.
Always. So he's like, dude, I'm gonna tackle the elephant in the room, and I'm gonna kill you with it.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. And even skipping down here, we're a little ahead. He said, "Look at my album plaque. Somebody agrees with the music." You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Nas has been—he's a platinum-selling artist. Platinum, meaning millions of records sold. So clearly, you know what I'm saying? People enjoy his music. So that just brings that home, man.
Yep.
You not for me. You bore me. I'm not gonna sound like every cookie cutter record in the top 40 with an 808 in it. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
I'm gonna give you something different. And my lyrics, they purchase. My poetry. And that's the power. That's how amazing Nas is. Even if you don't, you can say what you want. You know what I'm saying? About the beats.
Yep.
But his lyrics are so incredible. His lyrics are so impactful, so well written.
They stand the test of time.
So well crafted that they can carry beats, you know what I'm saying, that probably he shouldn't have used, you know what I mean? A little shout at Vlad TV as well. Vlad's not the first to say that, you know what I'm saying, but he was probably the most famous personality in the industry to say that. So that was a little dig at Vlad and everyone else who said it about Nas. So fire.
Hate to brag, my worst batch kills off your best cutie. Foxes deep, we break up, they hook up with athletes, get married, cause we wasn't that match, my G. Simple things in life. It's the simple things in life, simple things in life. We discussing buying acres, other safe bets. Nothing regular or basic. I just want my kids to have the same peace I'm blessed with.
Wow, that cut super fast. Man, I really like that beat though, man. And I really wish that could have been a longer song with a hook that was actually like that could have probably been a radio cut, man. The beat was that hard to me. If it had a little bit more in the chorus, I thought the chorus was very, very simple. But kind of simple things, I get it. But fire.
Simple things in life.
I get it. So, my conclusion of the whole album, man, for him to have this long of a layoff, man, I miss hearing Nas's voice, man. And for him to have this long of a layoff and come back, I think he came back hard. You know what I mean? It's going to be interesting to see what other people think about this album. But five, everything, Adam and Eve, Simple Things, I thought was fire. I did like Not For Radio. I did like that cut, and I thought that was going to have the same momentum throughout the whole track. But I think it kind of lost steam after that and picked back up with everything, Adam and Eve, and Simple Things. So
yeah.
So for me, man,
like the album.
Yeah, for in its totality, I like the album. I like the album.
Just to talk about Simple Things, man, before I get to my conclusion, I just thought that this was a dope song. I thought the beat was hard. I agree with Ryan on the chorus. I do think the chorus is the simple things in life. I thought the chorus was a little basic. You know what I'm saying? I thought they could have did something more with the chorus, but Nas's lyrics are so fucking ridiculous.
Yeah.
Nas can just, he can get away with so much that other people just can't get away with just because he's just lyrically gifted. You know what I'm saying?
That's so true, though. That is so true.
And and I like that, though. I like how he brought it home. He kind of took his shots. Like, man, I think this is Nas' way of saying, man, yo, do you know who I am? You better respect me. For you to even think that you can try to diminish what I've accomplished and what I've done for hip-hop by trying to just diminish me down to someone that's just a rapper that just picks bad beats and that's it is ridiculous.
Yeah,
you know what
right.
I'm saying?
You're right.
So he took that time to kind of check a couple people.
Uh-huh.
But he brought it home by saying, you know, man, I just want my kids to live in peace, right? To find the same peace that he did or something like that he said at the end. And I thought that was great. You know what I mean? Because it is the simple things in life. So, dope song. As for the album, I do think that this album suffered from some unfinished production is what I want to call it. I do think it suffered from maybe being rushed a little bit. I think even in some of the vocals, I do love everything. I think that's the best song on the album. Right now, I think that at least off of first listen. But I even think like Kanye's vocals were a little rough on that, even though it was still tolerable because the song in its totality was great. And I think White Label had a cool sample, but he didn't really do much with that sample. I would have liked to see that sample just chopped up a little bit more, maybe add some dynamic drums in there, add some different details in that to make that a little bit more dynamic. It just felt like a looping sample. Cop Shot the Kid, same thing, repetitive sample that I think he could have just cut that out and really just let that rock in the chorus, because that's hard. It's just, I just think it was a little bit too much hearing it throughout the entire song, and it kind of started to annoy me. Not For Radio was okay. So really from everything, Adam and Eve and Simple Things, I think is where the production really, I felt that marriage was made. And I don't know at what point they made these songs, but I felt like if I'm a betting man, I'm betting that those songs were probably made
together,
right? Mm-hmm. I just feel like there was a little bit more put into the production of those songs. And you really see the marriage that Nas and Kanye can really have, man, when they have the right combination
of
production and lyricism. So I thought that this was a good album. Good album from a hip-hop legend. And I think even from the songs that were lacking in production, Nas's ability to kind of to paint these pictures, man, and to drop gems and wisdom, knowledge, and just positivity and encouragement and pride as it relates to Black culture, really almost made up for the lack of production in those other songs, man. So dope album from Kanye and Nas. I'm gonna be rocking this joint. I'm gonna rock this joint on the way home tonight, man, to see what's going on. So that's the end of the video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please hit that like button. And also, if you guys are interested in joining our Patreon community, the link's down in the description. You will get early access to our content. So, you know, check that out if you're interested. And this is Lost in Vegas. George, Ryan,
we out.
We out.